What's up, you guys? It's Amanda. I go by Mandarin here on my social channels, and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here to my channel, I basically like to do beauty and fashion videos. So if you like this kind of videos, you might want to give this video a thumbs up and also subscribe. Hit the notification bell so that you can be notified all the times that I upload. But if you are someone here returning to my channel today, you'll probably notice that I had another identity crisis. Yes, my hair is platinum blonde. I would say that this is pretty platinum blonde. I know probably you guys wish I would have filmed how I got the blue and pink out of my hair. If you didn't see my hair, go ahead and check out my last video. But being a licensed professional, I didn't want to necessarily show you guys how to go platinum at home. I had to cut some corners that I maybe wouldn't have done in the salon to really get it out of my hair in a really short amount of time. So I just wanted to make sure that if I do make any hair videos for you guys, I want it to be something that isn't going to damage your hair and that anybody can do at home, whether you're professional or not. So that brings me to the subject of the video that we are going to be filming today. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how you can tone your hair extensions at home. Easy peasy, you don't need anything super fancy. All you're gonna need is a little bit of warm water and your favorite purple shampoo. If you're watching this video, I'm going to be assuming that you're probably already a platinum blonde and that you have a favorite purple shampoo at home. If you don't have a favorite purple shampoo, I can totally recommend you guys some of my favorites. These are the current purple shampoos that I use on my hair personally. We have the Matrix Brass Off Shampoo. I leave this in my hair for about 5 minutes when I really, really want to get that icy tone. And then you can see this is actually wet because it just got out of my shower. I use this about once a week. This is the Redken Color Extend Blondage Express Anti-Brass. And this one is actually a mask that you leave on your hair for 10 minutes at the maximum, it says, just to make sure that your hair gets super, super icy. And this one is also conditioning and smells amazing. This is actually a lot stronger than the Brass Off. So I really, really love this. And very soon I'm going to be trying a new mask. So I'll probably be making a video on that, so keep your eyes out for that. If you cannot get your hands on either of these salon products, you would probably have to buy these in a salon if you're not licensed. If you are licensed, you can get these at Salon Centric. And if you can only go to like Sally's, you can go ahead and get the Shimmer Lights Shampoo. I know a lot of people like that as well. So these are going to be the hair extensions in question that I'm going to be matching to my hair. These are the Zala 100% Human Hair extensions. You are going to want to make sure that your hair extensions are human hair or else they won't take color, and also they're just way better quality. So I've actually had these extensions for a while, never really wore them very much, haven't even washed them yet. Actually had these for sale for a while, but now that I am a blonde again, I took them down because I want them. But these are the Zala hair extensions. I believe they're either 20 or 22 inches, but you can see that, but even with the lights, you can see here that I have the Beachy Blonde, and actually have a volumizer weft in here as well that came in the platinum color, but even the one that came in the platinum color, which is this one, it's kind of got like a rosy platinum look to it. It would match, but the rest of them are very much more yellow. As you can see, this is my hair versus the extensions. It's much more icy, much more white looking, and you can actually make your extensions look just like that, just as white, without having to lift them. You definitely want to take care of your hair extensions because they don't have the natural oils like your own natural hair would. So you want to do the least damaging things to your extensions. Without further ado, I'm going to show you how to make your yellow hair extensions white. Okay, so the first thing you're going to want to do is, you can do this in your sink if you want to. I just brought a bowl out so you guys can see everything nicely. You're going to want to put lukewarm to warm water because you are going to be putting shampoo in the water. So you want to make sure that the shampoo, when you mix it, can kind of evenly saturate the water. And excuse my nails, you guys, it's quarantine. It's just rough out here. So I'm actually going to go ahead and I'm going to first take the Brass Off shampoo. And I do use this in my actual hair as well, so I'm gonna put a little bit of this just for extra strength into the water as well. Definitely make sure that you have a towel nearby because they are going to be wet. So you can see how this has a yellow tone to it. And I'm just gonna put it into the purple water and submerge it and just let it sit for a little bit. One thing about hair extensions is they actually soak up color pretty quickly, I find. So you don't want to leave them for too long, because if your hair is not silver, you don't want the hair extensions to look a completely more silver look than your hair. But until they kind of look like how your hair looks wet, you want to wait for them to look wet like that as well. So when you take it out, you're just going to want to wring the water out. And you can do another rinse like in your sink or whatever. I just have the soapy water, so you're just gonna wanna rinse it out. I only left it in for very little amount of time, under a minute, like 30 seconds. And you can already see that this piece, it looks a little bit silvery, and this is the color it was dry. So that was really quick, it was like magic. And if your extensions are long like mine, you're just gonna wanna be careful not to like knot them up. You just put in the water. Why is that so, this is so satisfying to me. So you can see, you don't need to leave them in for very long whatsoever. Another tip is, especially if you have thick hair extensions, like these ones from Zala are really nice and thick, and they do kind of like almost grow in the water. Like the first time you wash extensions, they kind of just like volumize up. You're gonna wanna like maybe comb through them with your fingers a little bit, just because you wanna make sure that there's no dry pieces that you miss. So these are the extensions wet. You can tell that they definitely have a silvery look to them. And these are kind of multi-dimensional, so it's kind of cool. There's gonna be like whiter pieces and more like silvery pieces, and it's gonna be really pretty. Obviously the hair is wet and they are extensions, so you wanna make sure that you comb them out with a wet brush, or a brush that's gonna be really gentle on the hair. And you make sure that you use, this is what I'm using, but you want to just use a detangler or a leave-in conditioner, preferably.
Alright, so I went ahead, I washed the extensions with the purple shampoo, and I did the honors of blow-drying a piece so you can see how much more white, silvery white, and beautiful this hair is. It looks gorgeous. Now it looks a little fluffy because it's just been blow dried, hasn't been styled at all, but it still feels silky soft and amazing and no damage whatsoever. And you can see now it's going to match basically perfectly into my hair because I use the same shampoo as I did in my hair on the extensions, which is like magic. I also want to make another quick note. If you are like me and watch videos that are completely not made for you, and you are a brunette, I have good news for you. If you have hair extensions that are brunette, but they are way too warm, meaning they pull a little bit of an orangey shade, there is actually a color by Matrix as well, with the Matrix shampoo, that is sort of a greenish blue color. And that will take out the orange if you have brassy brown hair extensions. You just go on the other side of the color wheel, a little bit of cosmetology 101 to cancel out and neutralize those tones. If you guys want a review on the extensions, or want to see how I apply them, because I'm going to be leaving the rest of the extensions to just air dry because it's much better for them, let me know down below, because these are brand new extensions. I have not really tested these. It's the first time I've actually washed them. So if you guys want any type of video regarding these extensions a little bit further, let me know. So that is it for today's video. I hope that you guys learn some tips and tricks for your hair extensions going from yellow to absolutely platinum blonde white. Really easy peasy, but I think every blonde should know how to do this with their extensions. If you haven't subscribed already, join my Mandarin Oranges family by hitting subscribe. As always, I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video as much as I enjoyed making it for you, and I will see you guys in the next one.